It's working.
The story of Countdown. Countdown was a British comic book that ran for 132 issues from the 20th of February 1971 to the 25th of August 1973. The pages in each issue were numbered in reverse order, with page 1 at the end. Countdown was edited by Dennis Hooper, who had been the original art editor on TV21. Countdown was obviously a rival to Lookin at the time, which ironically was being edited by Alan Fennell, the original editor of TV21. Countdown was quite a coup for Polystyle, its publishers, as they had gained the license to use Gerry Anderson strips after TV21 relinquished it. However, after the real-life moon landing of 1969, kids were less interested in space fantasy, and although Countdown was an excellent comic, it was out of its time. Back in 1971, the first issue of Countdown would cost you 5 new pence. Today, they fetch a whole lot more. The title changed slightly in the course of the run. Issues 1 to 18 were known as Countdown. Issues 19 to 45, Countdown the Space Age Comic. Issues 46 to 56, Countdown for TV Action. Issues 57 to 58, TV Action in Countdown. Issues 59 to 100, TV Action plus Countdown. And issues 101 to 132, just known as TV Action. Most of the TV Action Countdown comic strips feature the Doctor travelling alone. Up to issue 104, the TARDIS is still confined to Earth, although the Doctor is a bit more in control. It also features a pre-season 10 interior of the TARDIS. Some of the comic strips would be promoted to the front cover of TV Action as the big story, like Doctor Who in The Labyrinth, and where Doctor Who meets the Daleks in The Threat from Beneath. Doctor Who, The Spoilers. And Doctor Who and the Unheard Voice. There were also a number of holiday specials. Countdown, including UFO and Doctor Who. TV Action and Countdown Holiday Special, featuring the Persuaders, Hawaii Five-O, UFO, and, of course, Doctor Who. And TV Action Holiday Special, which also featured a photograph of the editor, Dennis Hooper, interviewing John Pertwee on location. There were also 2 Countdown annuals. The 1972 Countdown annual on the left, and the 1973 Countdown for TV Action annual on the right. And in 1974, it was the TV Action annual, featuring the Protectors, Alias Smith and Jones, and Hawaii Five-O. Other comic strips that featured in Countdown and TV Action were The Persuaders, which starred Roger Moore and Tony Curtis as Lord Brett Sinclair and Danny Wilde. The Protectors, featuring Robert Vaughan as Harry Rule. The series also starred Nari Dawn Porter. Cannon, starring William Conrad. The Adventures of an Overweight Private Investigator. Gerry Anderson's Thunderbirds. Some of these strips were reprints from TV 21. Hawaii 5-0. UFO from 1970, a series created by Gerry Anderson and Sylvia Anderson, and starring Ed Bishop as Commander Straker. The Cartoon Adventures of Droopy. Motor Mouse and Autocat. Gerry Anderson's Captain Scarlet and the Mysterons. Some of these comic strips were reprints from TV 21. Captain Scarlet. Comic Fun with Dick Dastardly and Muttley.
Muttley, you snickering, floppy-eared hound. When courage is needed, you're never around. Those medals you wear on your moth-eaten chest should be there for bungling at which you are best, so...
Stand by for action!
Gerry Anderson's Stingray, featuring Troy Tempest.
About to launch Stingray.
Stingray, 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 Stingray. Also, Fireball
XL5. I wish I was a spaceman, the fastest guy alive. I'd fly you round the universe in Fireball XL5. Way out in space together, conquerors of the sky.
And Dad's Army.
Who do you think you are kidding, Mr. Hitler, if you think we're on the run? We are...
Mission Impossible. Gerry Anderson's Thunderbirds Are Go, Zero X. Other stories featured were Alias Smith and Jones and Tightrope. The comic strips featured some great artwork by artists like Harry Linfield, John Burns, Brian Lewis and others, plus better than average scripts for comics of that period. Later issues of Countdown also reprinted some early TV 21 strips. Countdown was the best adventure comic of the 1970s.
Oh, and thank you.